Toy gun, and it's, parts of it are a Nerf gun. The interior here is a Nerf gun, and everything else, we've gutted it, and the interior is wood. And this is all handcrafted wood stuff. So it's just this outer shell from a Nerf gun because it was especially geary. And then we added a bunch of gears and decorative bits to it, and then we made the removable barrels to do the transport. But yeah, this is his volley gun, and the idea is that if you guys are familiar with old guns, which are kind of weird, they had, back before they had like a lot of machine guns, they would just have a gun with lots of barrels that would fire bullets out of everyone all at once. Like a bunch of barrels and a bunch of little hammers and just boosh, like 700 bullets coming at you.
If I shoot 900 bullets, I have to do it this
way. Exactly. Before, they really were like caring about accuracy with guns, and it's just massive amounts of bullets. And then they were like, well, why don't we just have shotguns and have lots of little bullets inside of a shell? And they're like, it doesn't look as cool, but I guess it's more efficient. It's certainly one shell and like 700 bullets into a gun, and it's supposed to keep firing. So the notion is that it redirects the steam so that he can fire barrels individually, or that giant cannon in the middle of it, which is like a huge slug, or knives and forks, or whatever shot. So, the volley gun.
The barrel on that from the Nerf gun?
No. We made everything else. Just the outer shell of the middle part is part of the Nerf gun. We kind of pull junk together from absolutely everywhere.
There's a toilet paper roll, unbelievably.
Literally,
a toilet paper rolls on that gun.
A lot of people ask me where we get our materials, and my answer is always everywhere, literally everywhere, on the side of the road, in dumpsters. We do a lot of dumpster diving. We'll go, we'll get in the car,
expensive shopping,
really late. In the car, really late at night, with music, and we'll drive around to office parks and lurk in the darkness.
Other than like hardware supplies from Walmart or Home Depot, we generally find stuff in antique stores or in the garbage or old toys that we had a million years ago.
Yeah,
it's literally garbage. And like you were saying, you can go on the Brass Goggles and they discuss what is steampunk. And you can take anything and turn it into steampunk. If you just do it right. You know, if you take a toilet paper roll and you glue it to your forehead, that's obviously not really anything at all. It's great. If you paint brass, you stick wire coming out of it, you stick like a bug on the other end to make like a cage. And yeah, you started off with the toilet paper roll. So, anything can be anything, and you'll learn when you come up with new stuff, you'll recognize the things. You'd be surprised if you're like, dude, that's my Lakers set.
Obviously, some materials work better than others, because it is more difficult to make some things look not modern. Because there's like a lot of materials that obviously somebody in a neo-Victorian quasi-future past fancy land. They wouldn't have plastic, so you've got to kind of make plastic look like something else. So that's kind of the trick, is to make it look like it was made a long time ago with old timey time materials, but has a science fictiony futuristic concept. Like jetpack is obviously not a Victorian notion, but if you make it look like it's made out of old stuff, and then you have kind of old fashioned looking.
So that's technically.